Good evening, everyone. We'll call to order the regularly scheduled council meeting for December 19th, 2016, at 7 p.m. Mr. Collier?
Mayor Lowry?
Here.
Mr. Reynolds?
Here.
Mr. Lindsay?
Here.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Here.
Mr. McLaughlin?
Present.
Mr. Kraybuck?
Here.
Six members present.
Thank you, sir. And tonight, I have the invocation by Councilman Lowell McLaughlin.
Everyone, please, if you bow your head. Lord, thank you so much for allowing us to be together. Thank you for our health. Thank you for these meetings. And please help this council, as well as the staff, with the workings of the city, do the right thing for our citizens. And please make sure we have enough salt for this winter. God bless America, our troops, and all of our firemen, policemen. In your name, Lord, amen.
Amen. We'll do the pledge sign. We use this flag here.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We need action on the regularly scheduled council meeting of December 5th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
Any questions or comments, council, before we move to a vote?
Not here.
Mr. Collier, when you're ready.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. Kraybuck?
Yes.
Mayor Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Minutes past 6-0.
Thank you, sir. Moving on, here in just a moment, we're going to, I would assume somebody is going to make a motion to appoint someone, a new council member, to fill Bill McIntyre's seat that's empty at the end of the table. Before we move on to that, I just want to thank everyone who did put in an application. We had a lot of good applicants and a lot of smart people that they put in for it. It would be nice to have probably a handful of those applicants on council, but unfortunately, we can only pick one at this time. So I don't know if anybody else has.
Mr. Mayor?
Mr. McLaughlin?
I would like to nominate Mr. James Lefley for the council seat that's been vacated by William McIntyre.
I second.
Is that Mr. Kraybuck or the second?
Yes.
Any discussion?
Any discussion?
Before we take a vote, I'd like to thank all of you for being here tonight. I'm going to be resigning at the end of this meeting tonight, so we're going to need another council member, probably go through the same process again the first of the year. So if the vote goes through for whom I just nominated, please make sure that you come again at that point. That's coming from me. Outstanding, all of you are outstanding, believe me. And thank you for being here again tonight.
Council, any other comments?
I do have a question for Gene. We have to go through the advertising and the application and the interview all over again.
Yes.
So within 30 days, we have to fill his seat too.
Here's what I would suggest we do when we advertise it, is that you advertise for any additional applicants and not go through the process of re-interviewing all the original people before if they're still interested. So if you get some additional applicants, you would interview, say you get one or two of those, and not interview six more people again or seven more people again.
Okay, so are we allowed to do that? You know, I thought we would have to go through the whole process again.
You're allowed to do it however you want, you know.
Okay, well, we'll deal with that when it's official. So, anyone else have any questions or comments? You can call for the vote, sir.
Mayor Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
No.
Mr. Lindsay?
No.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. Kraybuck?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-2.
Thank you, sir. And with that being said, I would assume, Mr. Leckley, you don't have a packet for tonight, since we didn't know, but you can, he can come take his seat.
Need to do the oath of office.
Right, let's say, he's going to come up here and stand, and then Gene is going to assume stand in front of you and swear you in, sir. Correct?
That's the way you choose?
Or would you rather him stand over here?
No, I mean, you, we can do it right there. I can do it from here, and he can stand there, put his right hand up, and we're good. Give me your right hand, sir. I'll go real slow on this, because I know when you're in front of people, it's, you can get a little, you can get tough.
It's tough for me to talk in public, yes.
State your name.
Jim Leckley.
Do solemnly swear or affirm?
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
Will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
The Constitution of the State of Ohio.
Constitution of the State of Ohio.
And the Charter and ordinances of the City of New Carlisle, Ohio.
And the Charter and the ordinances of the City of New Carlisle.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Honestly.
Honestly.
And impartially.
And impartially.
Discharge the duties of my office to the best of my ability.
Discharge the duties of my office impartially.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Well.
And I'll push it.
Mr. Mayor, point of reference.
Since he just sworn in, he hasn't had a packet, should he not really vote on anything that we have going on?
Yeah, I would assume that he wouldn't. It'd probably be best.
Technically, it starts today.
I know. But again, he hasn't had time to look at these or do whatever.
Yeah, he won't need to.
He won't vote in this one, but the next.
Correct.
Just wanted to.
Just for some of you also notice, Randy, City Manager Randy Bridge isn't not in tonight. He had some personal business, I'll say, that he had to attend to. Some bad news on his end, so we wish him the best, and hopefully he'll be back soon. That being said,
Before we move on, can we discuss and decide how we want to do this? Because you will need to probably identify another date to interview.
Right.
And how you actually, if you want to re-interview everybody, that's fine? Or
I would say
you do?
Interview everybody.
Okay, all right.
I would think that if the current or previous applicants are interested in the second seat, that they either do another application or make it known to us so we can use the same application possibly.
Yeah, if they've got it saved, they could probably call Randy, and Randy can just say it's been resubmitted.
Right.
Let's do it this way. Let's make their frame of reference me, so that I will schedule, and that way they won't have to worry about Mr. Bridge or whatever, because he likes to stay neutral in those situations and needs to. So we'll know.
So how would they contact you?
Email.
Email, phone number.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll tell you what, let's save this for the end when he.
Okay, let's do that.
Let's save that for the end when he does his official announcement. Okay, so moving on, communication. Just finish that city manager's report. Mr. Kitko.
Yeah, thank you, Mayor. Good evening, council, members of the public. Small item before I go on. We kind of had some of the packets. I didn't get the extra packets with the way the transition with Randy having to have his emergency and mine. We do not have in the packets, I don't believe in your packets, is the fire discussion or the police report. So on his asterisk, it says to be handed out. So what we'll do is tomorrow I can get emailed out or printed and put in the box the police packet and the fire packet. And if there's any questions or anything, we can follow up with that stuff.
Okay.
Thank
you.
Item A on your action report, Bell Manor, that is still ongoing. We were to have a meeting today. However, that got canceled because Randy was not available. We'll be rescheduling that, and then we'll keep council posted as updates come available. Moving on to B, your finance discussion. Ms. Harris will have your report.
Thank you, Mr. Kitko, Mayor, Council, and members of the public. This is our November finance report. The total amount of revenue we took in for November was $384,395.13. Total expenditures for November was $618,768.83. And I'll stop and get into a little bit of detail right there. Most of the large amount for our accounts payable in November, our expenditures, we did cut a check to the auditors for the Twin Creeks. That was $180,060.67. We had two of our semiannual debt payments that came in those expenses in November. That was $85,656. And then our annual city liability was $76,000. So out of the $618,000 expenditures for November, $342,000 of that half was unusual one-time expenditures. So now I'll move on. Our estimated revenue budget for 2016, we are at 98% collected. We've collected so far $5,536,580.97. And for our appropriations or our expense budget to date, we have spent $4,651,449.78, and that's about 80%. So we're still watching our expenditures very closely. Our income tax collected for the month of November for the general fund is $58,359.14. And with the 0.5% police income tax we collected for November, $25,666.46. Year to date in the general fund, then for the income tax is $1,025,194.18. And we did hit our estimated $500,000 in our 0.5% police income tax. We've collected so far $500,579.02. Then I have the rest of the finance report attached and check listings. If there's any questions, I can entertain.
Mr. Lindsay.
Ms. Harris, can we assume that the collections for the income tax for the police levy will be approximately this amount in December?
I actually went through right before the meeting, and so far for half the month I went and tallied, we have about $20,000 for the police levy. So we're looking at maybe, I'm estimating for the end of December about $520,000. So we still have some more coming in. It's just not a really busy month in December for collection.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Mr. Rhodes.
Colleen, I just went to the state treasurer's office. They gave me a call, and they said, like, we've not been in communication with them. This was right before Thanksgiving at all about the checkbook, and we were supposed to be online maybe October, November. Early December is what we were told. What's going on with that? Because now it's almost January.
The manager has been in contact with them. It's just we haven't been able to confirm the dates that they wanted to start. We thought it was best to wait till the end of the year, because what it's going to post is our totals. So if we posted and went online in October, we'd only have 9 months worth of expenditures to post. It's not something we do monthly. It's once a year, is our understanding. So I know that the city manager talked with them. We have a date set for, I believe, the second week in February. That gives us time. We have a lot of deadlines to close the end of the year and to get the totals correct and balanced. Then we'll be able to work with them to get those online, so they'll post, and then we go right into budget. So that's our window that is probably going to be able to work. And that's from the communications of us trying to get it put together.
At least right before Thanksgiving, is they have not had any contact with anyone.
I have several emails from the manager, so you might want to speak with him on the communication.
I just want to make sure, because I know he said it was sometime this year, and now it's coming next year. But as long as we get it up, it's all finished.
Ms. Harris, did you just say that you know this would only be updated once a year?
Correct.
Instead of every quarter?
We never talked about an exact time. We were, when we met with them, it was going to post the totals. And that's where we're going to start.
Yeah, we had I don't know if you guys got it out. There was an email that was sent out.
Yeah, I'm looking at it right now. December 15th from Mr. Bridge.
Right, okay.
Where he'd been in contact with.
Yeah. No, I agree.
Joshua Burton. First meeting is February 16th.
Just to touch on that, I thought it was at the beginning of the year we talked about, but maybe it was earlier in the year, but I also, are we going to be ready to do that early in the year, close to tax season? Are you guys going to be comfortable to get that set up and working?
It was what we came up with is the best window to try to keep everybody happy, to try to get the end of the year totals, which is the best posting to get it started. If we miss our window in February, we're right into budget in March, and then, you know, it gets, so we held those 2 weeks open. We were informed that it should not take very long. We'll see how that goes again. So that's our tentative, trying to get all of that put together.
The email states that from Mr. Bridge that they would like to target a meeting of the first or second week of February with Mr. Burton.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Mayor, funny. Mrs. Harris, you know, the general fund looks nice now. Well, why is the reason that it looks nice now? If you let everybody know the reason, we would be in big trouble, would we not, if we had not passed the police levy?
Exactly. We were extremely critical of going into fiscal watch before we cut the police department, and we asked the citizens to vote on that tax levy. The income tax levy that now supports the police department is also enough to build their reserve, so we're able to get the equipment that we need. But since that 0.5% of the police income tax goes for the police levy, now the general fund does not have to support that, and it's recovering. So it is a big thank you to the citizens for
Amen.
Putting that tax levy together.
Again, if we didn't have the police levy, we would be in trouble again, would we not?
We would have been in fiscal watch if we wouldn't have
right.
cut. And then
I just want everyone to know that that was a very crucial thing that happened with the city of New Carlisle. And again, Bill, thank you so much for your help on that, getting the police levy passed. That was instrumental in keeping this city afloat at that point.
Absolutely.
Very
and
much
we're
so.
Hoping to show how well the money has worked for the citizens and for this community
right.
To give that information back. So it's been very critical and very appreciated.
Right. You know, the difference is we see these figures like $5,673, $673,000. People think that we have all that money to spend like the general fund. That's not true. It's already dedicated to so many different operations within the city. Water is a big one, sewer is another, cemetery. There's so many other funds that are going on that people don't understand how the money in the city has to be allocated. It cannot be used in the general fund. The general fund is used for the day-to-day operations of the city otherwise than all these other funds that we're talking about. So it seems like there's a lot of money there. There's really not, just to let everybody know that. Thank you very much.
Moving on to sea service discussion, I will have a couple small updates. First, leaf pickup. The schedule has ended. However, we do know we have piles out there that the snow had come and stopped us from being able to pick up the leaf machine. We are going around with the loader to try and pick up piles. I heard we're supposed to get in about the 40s by week's end. And if the leaves are not too mangled up, we will get the machine out to suck those up. Otherwise, we will be out with the backhoe. Any excess leaves that are not out as of today, they need to be really put in your trash can or taken over to Madison. We try not to plow them in, but I do know we had plowed a couple leaves in the drives and got those out. So we are out to finish those, hopefully by the end of this week. So added to that is the winter ice event we just had. It was very different. Most of my guys have been here 20-some years plus, had salted, and to them it was probably the worst. It wasn't the most ice we've ever gotten, but it was the worst in the way it happened. We actually had issues with our trucks getting down the road, specifically here by the grain elevator, where basically you have to salt backwards and run over a little bit for some of those hillsides. So it was, the roads were treacherous. We didn't use a whole lot of salt. We still have plenty in the barn. And as I had mentioned before in other council meetings, we still have 300 ton available to us. And I confirmed that again today with the mineral company that's available. So just FYI, those guys had a tough time. I know deputies were stuck just because they couldn't go up this little hill because of the ice. So I just want to put my hat, give my hats off to those guys for getting the roads safe again. That is all I had to put out. Is there anything for service discussion from me before I move on?
Any questions, Mr. Lifeline?
Mr. Mayor,
sir,
there was one other thing for finance I forgot. Would you let everyone know about this, the letter that we received about taxation again? The taxes are going to be done, Cleveland, the income tax notice that went out, I think, to all citizens.
Yeah, we are collecting through 2016, and then starting 2017, the company that we had introduced a few months ago, CCA, we have contracted their services to take over the income tax. So if you get a letter that says to get on our website and it goes to CCA, that is legitimate. That is what we are doing with our tax department starting in 2017. If you have any other additional questions, just call our office tomorrow and someone in the tax department can go through any other questions that you might have.
Thank you again.
You're welcome. Thank you, Mr. Lundy.
Mr. Harris, follow-up question to those. Is everybody in the city getting one of these letters?
Yes.
According to the rolls that the city currently has?
According to,
The tax rolls that you currently have, that the city has?
I believe so. I haven't even received the letter myself yet. Vicki has been taking on that part of it, so I would have to just double-check with her.
I do know that today I met with the website person. I do have all the documents that Ms. Taylor has given me as far as all the old ordinances that pertain to 2014, 15, 16, and beyond. All those documents are with the web company right now, getting all the links put together. So when you go to the website, hopefully within a day or so, where the Are You Okay link was on the front page, that will say income tax information. You'll click on that, and it will take you to a slew of legislation, rules and regulation links, and then a link that will take you to the City of Cleveland Department of Taxation and stuff like that. So at least I know that'll be on there within the next couple days. And those rules and regulations includes all our ordinances associated with anything that's ever happened for tax with the City of New Carlisle.
All right. Thank you, sir. I just want to touch on one thing real quick on finances before we move on, since this is the last meeting of the year and talking about how our budget is and things. It's been talked about a few times here and about the pool. I was a big supporter of the pool. The pool made a huge
turnaround.
Yeah, turnaround. Thank you. A huge turnaround this year. 3 years ago, the pool lost $40,000. 2 years ago, it lost, I think, $4,700. And this year, it's under $2,000 loss, which is phenomenal for a pool, I think. For this year's work at the pool, it paid off with all the hard work of the council members that came up and helped the city workers that under Howie's belt there that come up and did a lot of hard work in the actual pool itself. The citizens that stepped up and helped paint, donate money to put new paint on the building. It was a good effort by the city and the citizens itself. So that was nice to see. So just good work on the pool to everyone involved with it this year. Mm-hmm.
And hopefully you do a better job next year. You did a good job.
I didn't do it. I helped, but I didn't do it. So.
I know we haven't passed the CIP report yet, but I did notice that in your department you get new software. You're requesting new software, and it talks about online payment. Now, is that going through the city here, or is that going through the Cleveland?
We're working on also being able to pay the water and sewer bills online.
Oh, sorry.
That's a little bit of a cost, but most of the capital for the software is actually for our fixed assets, and these are a recurring project that we have been trying to get done. It's on one of our, it's always on our audit notes about trying to get a better fixed asset process. So we need to get some software to help us. We have to value the city. We have to go through and get a starting point on what everything's worth. And then we can pick up and continue it on our own. So that's in my wish list. If it comes up, we might be able to try to do that next year.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. All right, moving on. When you're ready, sir.
Thank you. Moving on, there is no planning and zoning discussion tonight. Go down to E, fire discussion. Chief Trustee, if you could, please.
Good evening, Mayor, Council, and citizens. For the month of November, the New Carlisle Fire Division responded to 81 EMS calls in the city, 7 EMS calls in Elizabeth Township. The division responded to 6 fire-related calls in the city and 1 in Elizabeth Township. We had 3 EMS calls answered by Mutual Aid, Pike Township, or Bethel Park due to Medic 1 already being on a response. We answered 2 Mutual Aid calls to Bethel Park or Pike Township while their medics were out. Medic 52 responded to 4 calls during the month, which means that we had enough people in the city that's living in the city now that's on the division to come in and respond out the second medic while our first run medics out already on a response, which is a big improvement for us this year. We had 1 fire run this month, which was a malicious intentional set fire behind IGA. Several bundles of their cardboard was set on fire. It was turned over to the deputies for investigation. They were on scene at the same time we were. We could tell that it was a malicious malicious intent. So, on the EMS side of the house, Assistant Chief Geiselman performed 2 CPR classes for a total of 10 people at no cost to them. Chief Geiselman has been working hard with that project this year. She has 2 other EMS officers now that are also CPR certified, and they're willing to teach classes for anybody that needs it, whether it be 1 person or 20. Just get in contact with the division, with the station, and we'll set you up with Chief Geiselman. The division would like to thank the citizens and everyone in the city that donated cases of water and Gatorade for the fire victims in Gatlinburg. With your help, we were able to donate over 100 cases of water and Gatorade to the fire victims down there, and also to the firefighters fighting the fires. It's another case of not just New Carlisle Fire Division, but all the local fire departments getting together and helping someone in need. It was a combined effort between us, Bethel Clark, Bethel Miami, all the surrounding departments. And that is just one of those things, when one hurts, we all hurt. We still have smoke detectors available to the citizens. Just please call the station and crews will set it up to come out. And I would like to ask that everyone would keep the division in your thoughts and prayers. We had a tough day. This morning, our medic crew got toned out for a medical call that turned into a full arrest, and one of the crew members, it was their aunt. Mm. And that's a hard call.
One of the crew members was?
That's a tough call. It's their aunt.
So please, the division's kind of hurting tonight. On another high note, my wife sent in one of her Christmas trays. Please, I'm not allowed to take anything home. Any questions?
Counselor, any questions, comments? Chief, yeah. I just wanted to say thanks for the surprise last night. I was at my house celebrating my son's 14th birthday, and we're all in the living room and kitchen area, and my daughter's in the living room watching TV and knocked at the door. My daughter's 12, and she's like, opens the door, and you look at her face, she's like, "Dad, I think it's for you." I was like, "Well, who is it?" She's like, "You need to come here." And I go out there, and there's, you know, 6 firefighters singing Christmas carols in my front yard. So it was, you know, my wife and the kids, like, now we are really in a Christmas spirit. Now we've never had Christmas carolers, so.
Hey, your dog enjoyed it.
Yeah, the dog did enjoy it. So that was really neat. So thank you. It was a nice surprise. And
we went there. We went to a few houses. We also went to both the nursing homes in the city.
That's fantastic.
Great idea. I think we ought to give you guys a hand for that.
How is any update on your funds for the Lucas tool?
Right now, we're still sitting at what we have, the right around between $6,000 and $7,000 for it, and
okay,
still going.
Great. Thank you. Okay, any questions? Thank you, Chief Trustee.
Thank you, Chief. I guess Sergeant Underwood did not make it. That wasn't on purpose to shorten the meeting up or anything like that. But again, I will get these handouts printed out if there's anybody. I will also send an email. If you don't want a hard copy in your mailbox, I've done. I mean, I can do whatever we need to do. But
that's fine for me.
Is email fine with everybody that wants to make? Okay. All right. That way I don't have to make a bunch. And then can I email yours over then? The reports when I get them? Okay. Moving on down to G, informational items. This has been on the packet for some time now. Waste management, please choose your new service level if you have not already and communicate that with waste management. If you were on the bag program prior and have not selected a new service level, you will automatically be entered into the standard level of service. I know we have had a few that have made multiple calls. They have come in and spoke with the city manager, and they got that resolved with the, I think, the district manager or whoever. And I don't know, I've heard there might be some carts are having to get made or whatever. There's a couple different reasons, but I do know if you have some issues and haven't got anything resolved, contact the city, and I think he's been able to assist a few people in getting that resolved. The next bullet item is the Ohio checkbook, as was talked about earlier. First meeting is set for February 16th. The next item upcoming, we will have budget work sessions. We're not setting anything tonight, but I think when Mr. Bridge comes back, we'll need to set a few budget work sessions in the future. The budget is due by Ohio Revised Code by April 1st of 2017.
Yeah.
Sorry.
A little late.
Tentative submission to City Council will be March 6, 2017 via resolution. And that tonight, Mayor, is all I have.
Thank you, sir.
You say March 6th?
Yeah, we'll probably be introducing it March 6th. That'll give us some time to get it up to the state.
Okay. Council, any questions for Mr. Kitko or Ms. Harris or Chief Trustee before we move on? All right. Thank you. We will be moving on to comments from the members of the public tonight. So, Mr. Cobb.
Ronald Cobb, 202 Villa Drive. A while back, this council, excluding a new member, entered into agreement with Waste Management for Mr. Bridge to get a contract with them. Services went downhill bad. They're late. They're not emptying the trash can. I had one driver look at me and want to know why I had two totes sitting there. I don't care if I got 10. I pay for it, you empty it.
Ron, did you, I couldn't hear what you said the first part. You said excluded something? I just didn't hear the first part.
Waste management, their service is going downhill.
I heard.
Tonight they didn't pick up the trash till 6 o'clock.
Okay.
Last week was 5:30. I had the driver stop and ask when I was out there, wonder why I had two totes. I don't care if I got 10. Right. I pay for it, you empty it. They're not fully emptying the cans. They just sit there, dump it one time, set it down, throw it up on the grass, and they're gone. Get it under control, or I'm gonna pursue it more. This is ridiculous. I know I was the only one that showed up when you had the meeting to discuss waste management. You know, and I blame the other citizens. They all want to complain, but nobody wants to sit here and say anything to council. But we need to nip it in the bud, or I'm going to take it farther.
Ron, my personal opinion is and you know, I've had a couple issues. I had to call them. They only emptied one of mine, and I had to call them, and they came right back. You know, I think it was within an hour or two. They emptied one, but they didn't get the other, and they were side by side. I don't know if he just got confused or whatever it was. Another thing that I've learned, I don't know if everyone else has, with them, is it called automated, where they got the army called automated mm-hmm. truck, mm-hmm. where it lifts it with the arm. I mean, every one of us, I think, sets like extra trash to the side, like if you've got a big toy box from Christmas, you set it to the side and they normally take it. They won't do that anymore because it defeats the purpose of the automated truck, which kind of stinks because we've all gotten used to it. But I also understand their point of view and why they do it that way. They're trying to make things more efficient. Howard, do you remember what the contract time is for them to finish their services? Is it 6 or 7?
7 o'clock. 7 o'clock.
Yeah,
seven,
I'm out.
It's 7 o'clock.
I didn't know if you knew.
I don't know it off the top of my head.
I mean, Ron, as far as them being late, I know I think we talked about this with you last time, and I think Mr. Lindsay brought up at the meeting with the waste management rep. I mean, if they're within the contracted time, I mean, I know that some people have gotten used to it being mm-hmm. emptied by, say, you know, 9, 10, depends on where you live. But as long as they're within that contract of time, I don't think there's anything you can do about it.
Okay, Michigan told me tonight the contract time was 4:30.
No.
No.
No, it's 7 to 7.
Well, I'm just telling you what I was told from corporate office.
Right. Well, we can check into it. I have no problem looking into it. But I remember at that last meeting with the rep from Waste Management, Randy, and said it was 7 to 7 or 6 or something like that.
But I mean, they need to empty the coach. That's what I'm paying for. And like I say, it doesn't matter if I got 20 or 10 out there. They get paid to empty that tote for what they're charging me.
Well, the only thing I'm going to say to that part is, Ron, is I don't know. I remember Randy had talked about with them switching over with the new contract that I thought Randy had said that there might be a, I don't know if you want to call it a gap or something, a system where it was changing over or something, and it was showing that you only had one, but you actually had two or something of that nature. I can't speak.
Well, 2 weeks ago here, he didn't even pick it up. I had to call him to come back and get it.
Okay, have you called him?
Yes.
Did they come back and get the second one?
The next day.
No. Okay, well, I will pass it on to Randy. We'll let Randy know.
Yeah, the first thing is that if you can't get it resolved directly with Waste Management, your next step is through the city manager.
Right.
No, sir. I'm contracted through Waste Management, not the city of New Carlisle. I will deal with Waste Management.
No, I
should not have to deal with you.
No, that's what he's saying. He's saying that if you can't get it squared away with Waste Management, come to Randy or us. And
I'll get it squared away if I got to go to Fairborn personally.
That is your right, sir.
But when I do that, I'm going to circulate a petition and run them out of here.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. Thank you, Ron. Anyone else tonight from the audience? Have any questions or comments? All right. Thank you. We will move on to committee reports. None tonight. And two resolutions, one to be introduced, one with action. Mr. Collier, you're ready, sir.
Resolution 16-13R, introduction, public hearing, and action tonight. A resolution adopting a capital improvement program for the city of New Carlisle, Ohio.
I'd like to make a motion for resolution 16-13R.
Second.
An explanation of this resolution, and you should have in your packets. Randy had, I think, sent this out about 2 weeks ago with a cover letter, or a week or two ago, with all the departments graphed and what their capital improvements are expected to be for this year. That's just the basic general information for it. I can try to entertain the questions and hopefully have some answers. If not, I'll have to maybe get back to you if they're not too serious.
Mr. Reynolds.
Just for a bucket truck, 10,000 in 18, 19, 20, is that just for repairs?
No, that would probably be looking to replace the bucket truck we have is an old Ohio Edison. So we would look to try and maybe take it out 3 years.
Okay, I was just wondering, yep. Because I didn't know what the cost of that would be.
Yep.
I just want to remind everybody on TV and also here that this is just a wish list. You know, it doesn't necessarily, this is set in stone.
To a degree.
Yeah. That's what, you know, Colleen called her is a wish list, and that's what it basically is.
Well, that's for my department.
Well, it's for anybody else, too. Yeah.
Oh, we take this this capital improvement program, and seriously, used to be like that probably a couple years ago. I would say a little more wish. This has been really thought out a lot deeper. It's definitely a lot shorter than ever it used to be, so some of them are a little more ironed out and detailed than before.
Okay, let me ask you that. There's two things, the wastewater and the water department looks like it, you know, are you revamping it or something? Because it looks like there's a lot in the next 2 years.
Can you go to the page and point me to where you're looking at? Start with water, I think.
Okay. Well, like the, you know, 2017, that the water CIP, page eight, you know, you got 196,000, then you got 206 in 2000, you know, it just seems like.
Yeah, a little bit of the total going up there. The major increase, and if you look at the description, is to paint the scarf tower that has not been touched since 1974, mm-hmm. Okay. And to go ahead and get that done. And we are looking to do that through a maintenance program.
Okay. Then page 7, you have on 2017, you got 178,000. In 2018, you got 195,000 on page 7. I know we have a problem with wastewater because it's not really up to par, to what.
Right, so correct.
Is that what you're trying to do?
Yeah, the biggest thing will be, before I get into that, is we are going to have, I'll be sending out an email inviting everybody for plant tours, water and wastewater, to get out and actually see some of the things I actually have listed for your eyes. One is the bar screen, which actually went out on us midway through this year from the 1980. It's actually gone and really out of service. So this is to put a new bar screen in there and upgrade it from what used to be the standard then to a standard now of treatment and removing more material before it even comes into plant.
Mm-hmm. Anything else, sir?
That's it.
All right, Councilman, any other questions? Mr. Collier, when you're ready.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher?
Yes.
Mayor Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Passes 6-0. And I will add that the city will be publishing the summary part of the CIP.
Should you, good point, even though he's more likely not going to vote, should we call him legally? He is here, he's on council. He can just abstain.
He can state not
abstain, yeah.
Not being
Mr.
able
Leithman.
To
do it. Okay.
Gene.
How'd that feel?
It's left.
No.
Left.
I abstain at home all the time.
It's not the same.
All right, Gene, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
That's all right. What was I talking about?
The summary of the CIP.
Yes. The summary of the CIP will be published in the newspaper. Mr. Grimm, obviously it's too late to get that in this week, but it's not too late. Get it to you tonight. He can give it. We can give it to you right now. You need it in email form.
Okay.
Can you send? I have it in the council packet, but I can't separate it out of the council packet.
Mr. Carter, I think I have a PDF of that. I can forward it to you.
Can you forward it to the newspaper?
To one of
them. You have this completed version with cover letter?
He said he can take that.
Yeah.
Okay.
It can actually be in on Wednesday?
Doubtful.
Pretty big.
At least not without.
This will also be with the budget when we start doing the budget work session.
Okay. All right. Moving on to ordinances, 0 to be introduced tonight, 3 with action.
Give me 2 seconds, sir.
Yes, sir.
Completed. Ordinance 16-54, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance to approve the editing and inclusion of certain ordinances as parts of the various component codes of the codified ordinances to provide for the adoption of new matter in the updated and revised codified ordinances, to provide for the publication of such new matter, and to repeal ordinances in conflict therewith.
This is the next. We adopt ordinance 16-54.
Does anybody need an explanation on why we do this?
Just new stuff.
It's just housekeeping.
It's housekeeping on it.
Everything can go online, directly to the Journal, legal publishing company, look it up, look at the ordinances and charter,
Updates everything and anything and any decisions you folks have made for the last year that go into codified ordinances. That's what it is. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of material.
When you're ready, sir.
All right. Mr. Lethley. Mr. Rick Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin.
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher.
Yes.
Mayor Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Pass 6-0. 6-0-1, I'm sorry. 6-0-1. Throwing me all off tonight. I'll get it.
You'll get to it.
I'll get there. Ordinance 16-55, public hearing in action tonight. Access to radio transmission facilities cooperation agreement.
Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Lowry.
Motion to adopt ordinance 16-55.
Second.
An explanation of this ordinance, basically I'm going to go from the body because I'm truly not up to speed on what this is for. Then Springfield, I think, has some towers in their area that we use probably to share our radio frequency, and we just basically are kind of sub-renting their time space on that tower. And I think it's for, it's really inexpensive, $6 per month per radio owned on January 1. I don't think it's that expensive.
That's how many radios do we have?
We have at, right at 70. That's including mobiles in the vehicles and handheld.
You said 70, 7-0?
Well, yeah, that much.
Well, I was thinking
NFPA regulations now, all NFPA regulations state that any fire apparatus will have a handheld radio for every riding position on the vehicle.
Oh, really?
Do you have one for the truck, one the maintenance, one the equipment, and one for personnel?
Awesome. Every firefighter entering the building must have radio capability.
Thanks.
Any other questions, Council? Mr. Collier, when you're ready, sir.
Is this second, Mr. Krabacher? Mr. Reynolds.
No, Mr. Reynolds is second.
All right, okay, let's do this again. Mr. Reynolds made the motion. And the second
made
the
motion. No,
that's what I
second.
Mr. Reynolds, he's second.
That's what I asked. If you made the second.
Yes. Oh, I thought you said he made the motion.
Yeah, you said I made the motion.
He asked who made the second.
I'm happy you and I didn't hear. So.
And that was you who said.
Cut.
Yes.
Gotcha.
These records correct.
Mr. Lindsay.
Yes.
Mr. Lethley.
I abstain.
Doing a good job.
Mr. Rick Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin.
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher.
Yes.
Mayor Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds.
Yes.
Passes 6-0-1. Ordinance 16-56, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance authorizing the leasing of a portion of the waterworks property of the city of New Carlisle, Ohio, to the New Carlisle Baseball Softball Association.
Mr. Mayor.
Mr. McLaughlin.
I move that we accept ordinance 1656 as written.
Second.
And as an explanation of this ordinance, for many, many years, the New Carlisle Baseball Softball Association has rented from the city of New Carlisle. It's right in our well field, and they just had baseball. This would be for years 2017, 2018, and 2019 to extend their lease for $1 to be paid at the end of it, prior to January 1 of each year. So in total, it'll be like $3. We do stay on top of them for cleanliness, maintenance, things like that. They've had some good presidents and vice presidents lately to help keep that property looking good. The only thing that would be is if the water department needs to make some adjustments in the well field, we hold basically a priority to make any adjustments to the lease if we have to remove a field, a playable field, because we had to put a well in the middle of it or something. So.
Council, any questions? When you're ready, Mr. Collier.
Mayor Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Mr. Lethley?
I abstain.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. Kraybaugh?
Yes.
Passed 6-0-1.
All right, thank you, sir. Before we move on to other business, I think Mr. McLaughlin has a few words he would like to say tonight. I'm correct, sir?
Are you ready for me now? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, we wanted to do this first.
I need to resign my office as councilman, yes. For the last 15 years, I've been on council. This is my 15th year, so I am resigning as of tonight as a councilman due to taking another position with the county, and which I will be holding my hand up the 28th of this month, be official then the first of the year. So I want to thank all of you that I've been partnering with here for these many years, and everybody up here and everyone over there. God bless you all and good luck. And with that, I do resign.
Mr. Lauer, one of you?
I just want to say thanks for your service to the city of New Carlisle and good luck in your new endeavors.
Thank you.
And Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your service.
Oh, you're
appreciate
welcome.
It. You've done very well, Lowell. Thanks. And hopefully we can see a lot of money coming our way now.
Exactly.
hold you to that, but seriously, thanks for everything you've done for me. Well, I know your heart's always been in 110%, and I appreciate it.
Yeah, still will be, believe me.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
I'm going to miss you.
You've been my friend for 20 years.
I have.
Yeah.
You're right.
He's still your friend.
Nice job.
Yeah, Lowell, I just want to say the same thing. Thanks for everything you've done for me, Paul. You've been a huge asset to the city. You've done tremendous work on everything you put your hand on, whether it's the festival, city council, many of the other things you've done. And I hope that the citizens of New Carlisle realize how important it is that we have someone from New Carlisle that's going to be on the Clark County's seat, because I think a lot of those guys sometimes forget to hear.
We all forget.
We are, New Carlisle is just as important to this county as anybody else, and I know you're going to be only one man and one vote, but I'm sure you'll do a fine job and best of luck.
Thank you. Appreciate it. So.
All right. Moving on to other business.
No, I just have one thing I'd like to say. I'd like to kind of reflect what was said in the last meeting. I think it was by Mr. Lauer here about our new sheriff in town, that Mr. McLaughlin, we hope to see you at quite a few of our meetings.
There you go. We'll have a council.
Not for any other reason, we'd just like to see you.
Okay.
You can stand
appreciate
up,
that.
You can stand up
out
on
there.
The podium.
You can say whatever you want.
And even bring a little information from the county once in a while.
That's right.
That'd be
great. All right, real quick.
Other business.
City offices will be closed this Friday, December the 23rd, and Monday the 26th for the Christmas holiday, and Monday, January 2nd, 2017 for New Year's. And I wanted to announce so everybody would know that this next meeting of this City Council will be Tuesday, January the 3rd at 7 p.m. So if you show up January the 2nd, nobody will be here. So it's Tuesday night in 2 weeks. That's all I have.
Also, I just wanted to remind everybody that coming up will be the New Year's Eve ball drop on Main Street. We'll be at Main and Washington again. As always, I think this is our 7th year doing it. It'll be a great time. Bring the kids out. It'll be from 9 to about 1 in the morning. This year we're having horse drawn carriages as part of the event on top of the ice sculptures that are going to be coming from Columbus, plus the food and the stores and the ball and music and dancing. So if you have time and you don't mind being on the cold a little bit, come out and join the fun.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Lauer.
I'd like to take an opportunity to wish everybody, not only the ones here, everybody looking through the camera up there, have a very Merry Christmas, and please stay safe and see you next year.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Chief?
One thing I forgot, it wasn't in our report. We had one of our senior citizens live in the area. She was very intelligent, she was really smart. She had someone call her posing as someone from the fire division asking to collect donations for burn victims. and she could, felt that it was a scam, so she told them, no, I gave them to the Shriners, and they got very rude with her and hung up. The number that she took down that had called her, tried calling it back, it was disconnected. What we did, she called the division and talked to me and gave me all the information. We turned around, we turned it over to the deputies for Miami County and Clark County, and we also turned it to the paper and put it out there, and we also put it on Facebook for New Carlisle. If you receive any phone calls like that, please hang up on them. The fire division does not and never will call and ask for donations over the phone in any way, shape, fashion, or form.
Thank you, Chief. Appreciate it. All right, well.
Mr. Mayor, move it with your adjourn.
Sir, everyone have a Merry Christmas.
Yes.